So firstly, I'll start with the concept of center of mass. Now, please keep on listening till 20-25 minutes. I'll be doing synopsis and then the first type of sums, that is introductory, checkpoint one. Center of mass is defined as a point. It is a point where all masses of system of particles are supposed to be concentrated. Example, suppose we have lot of system of particles, lot of particles are there, randomly arranged, lot of particles are there. Center of mass is defined as a point. So we'll concentrate every mass at one point, because Newton's laws of motion is not valid for system of particles. It is only valid for a point particle. So we have to concentrate all the particles at one point. So this is a hypothetical concept that this point is a point. It is an imaginary point where the whole mass of the body is supposed to be concentrated. So that what happens? So that, and this point is called a center of mass. So that if you apply a force at this point, the whole system is going to perform translational motion. Hello, what did I say? That there are a lot of particles in air. Okay, they are arranged anywhere in the coordinate system. Now, to apply Newton's law, we have to concentrate all the masses of system of particles at one point. So that if you apply force at that point, the body will perform translational motion. The whole system of particles will perform which motion? Translational motion. And this point is termed as what point, beta? Center of? Hello? What is it called as, beta? Center of mass. I'll give you another example. Suppose there is a table. Okay. Hello? Please reply today. Otherwise, it's very, very difficult to explain now. Suppose if I apply a force at this point, can anyone tell me what will happen? Will the table perform translational motion or will it topple? Hello? What do you think?
Topple.
It will topple. Barabar hai? Hello?
Yes, sir.
There will be more. Suppose there is another point. If I apply force at this point, no. I apply force at this any other point. What will happen again? Rotational motion or translational motion? Hello? Rotational motion or translational motion?
Rotational motion.
Rotational motion. By logic, if you say it is rotational motion again. Now what to do? So I have to select a point where the whole mass of the body is supposed to be concentrated. This point, termed as center of mass of the point of the whole table, where if I apply a force, can anyone tell me what will happen to the table? Will it perform rotational motion or translational motion now? Yes, sir?
Translational
motion. And this point in that body is called as which point, beta? Kya bolte isko? Center of mass, where the whole mass of the body is supposed to be concentrated. So as the body performs linear motion in accordance with Newton's law. Did you all understand? Hello? Yes or no?
Fine. Yes.
चलो भाई आगे बढ़ते हैं. प्लीज रिप्लाई. हां इज वेरी एक्चुअली इट इज अ वेरी ड्राई टॉपिक. ओके तो रिप्लाई करना पड़ेगा. यस
मोशन इन अकॉर्डेंस विद
न्यूटन्स लॉ. एफ एज एम ए. ठीक है ओके. नाउ देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ सिस्टम ऑफ पार्टिकल्स. वन इज डिस्क्रीट system of particles and second is continuous system of particles. Discrete ka matlab bikhra hua, all particles are there here, one other. Okay, discrete particles. Suppose this is a discrete particle system, m1 and m2, and suppose m2 is greater than m1. Can anyone tell me where will the center of mass lie? Center of mass is always near to the heavier mass. Yaad rakhna ye point. So center of mass will lie near whom? Come on man, please reply.
M2.
Always, huh? Center of mass is always near the heavier mass because there will be more mass concentration over there, na? Hello, according to definition. Hello. Ye center of mass. Getting it? हेलो यस और नो. ये सब इम्पोर्टेंट बातें हैं जो आपको आना चाहिए. इट इज नॉट लाइक अदर चैप्टर्स. हाँ ये थोड़ा ध्यान रखना पड़ेगा इस चैप्टर में. ओके नेक्स्ट. सपोज देयर आर थ्री पार्टिकल सिस्टम m1 m2 थोड़ा और भारी है एंड m3 इज द हेवीएस्ट एंड आई वांट टू लोकेट सेंटर ऑफ मास. तो क्या करेंगे? Suppose if I draw a line, can I say along this line, center of mass will be near whom? M1, M2. अरे भाई M1 और M2. M2 is bigger than
M2.
Can I say center of mass is over here? I don't know where is it, but I know that center of mass will be near to M2. Yes or no?
Yes sir.
अच्छा यहाँ पर और एक line बनाते हैं हम लोग. And I say, abhi M3 is greater than M1 plus M2. आप बता सकते हैं center of mass किसके नजदीक lie करेगा?
M3
के नजदीक है. ये center of mass resultant है. Getting it or not?
Yes.
तो ऐसे आपको basic question neet में आते हैं कि center of mass किसके नजदीक है. तो आपको answer क्या mark कर देना है? M3. Yes or no?
Yes sir.
Hello. This is the whole concept based on system of particles, basic system of particles. Okay. Now, आगे बढ़ते हैं हम लोग. Now we come to continuous system of particles. Continuous system of particles मतलब एक sphere. Where will center of mass lie? At the geometric center. There is a cube, or there is a disc. Center of mass lie will at the geometric center. Are you all getting it? Beta Hana, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Please reply. Huh? Yesterday, Virav sir was also shouting. Bhai, kya ho raha hai? Okay. Now, acha, chalo, idhar aajo. Suppose we have a half disc. Can anyone tell me? अच्छा इसका radius r है. Is this where is the center of mass lying? In the lowermost portion or the uppermost portion? Suppose if I divide this into two parts, ऐसे. Where will the center of mass lie? In the lower part or the upper part? Come on.
Lower part.
Why do you think so?
Because more mass is there in the lower part.
Concentrated, yes. So can I say this y, where the center, suppose ye center of mass hai yahan par. This y coordinate of center of mass will be lesser than r by 2. Hello? Yes or no? Middle mein toh rahega hi nahi na, uske bhi niche rahega. Yes or no? Hello?
Yes sir.
बेसिक चीजें है, मैं बेसिक चीजें बाद में आपको दे दूंगा, मैं किधर कौन सा किसका नंबर है, दैट आई विल गिव इट टू यू, बट हमको बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट आना चाहिए कि कहां पर लाई करेगा वो. नाउ इफ यू फिनिश्ड विद दिस स्लाइड, कैन आई गो टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड बेटा, कैन आई गो टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड, यस और नो? फाइन, ठीक है. सो आई एम डिफाइनिंग अ टर्म, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म कॉल्ड एज मास मोमेंट. Okay, always remember, mass moment is mass into distance. Can anyone tell me what does moment of force mean? Bhai, moment of force kya tha? Hello, moment of force kya tha? Moment of force. फॉर्मूला क्या था?
फोर्स इनटू परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस.
तो जब भी मोमेंट वर्ड आएगा ना, इट इज इनटू डिस्टेंस. कम ऑन मैन, प्लीज यार. मोमेंट ऑफ फोर्स क्या था? बिकॉज़ रिमेंबर ना, फोर्स इनटू परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस. वैसे मोमेंट ऑफ मास क्या रहेगा? मास इनटू डिस्टेंस. ओके, वेस कैन यू वन टेल मी व्हाट इज मोमेंट ऑफ मोमेंटम? Come on. Momentum into distance. ये चीज याद रखिए, जब भी वर्ड मोमेंट आता है ना, इट मीन्स इट इज इन टू डिस्टेंस. गेटिंग इट फिजिक्स में? हेलो हेलो, जैसे फिजिक्स में जब भी वर्ड रेट आएगा, रेट इट इज अपॉन टाइम ना, विद रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम, बराबर है? तो जब भी वर्ड मोमेंट आएगा, इट इज इन टू डिस्टेंस. Mass moment is mass into distance, and it is always calculated with respect to a reference point. So suppose this is a reference point O. And this is mass which is located, and this is the position vector of that mass with respect to O. So the mass moment is a vector quantity, will become Z bar, will become mass into position vector. Hello. Hello, hello, hello. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
ये चीज हमको याद रखनी है, मतलब इसका अभी फिलहाल इसका कुछ काम नहीं है इंडिविजुअली, बट इसका काम लगेगा सेंटर ऑफ मास में. ये कॉन्सेप्ट हमको याद रखना है. व्हाट इज मास मोमेंट मीन? मास मोमेंट इज मास इनटू डिस्टेंस, ऑलवेज कैलकुलेटेड विद रिस्पेक्ट टू अ रेफरेंस पॉइंट. लेट द रेफरेंस पॉइंट बी ओ. पोजीशन वेक्टर ऑफ दैट मास विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द रेफरेंस पॉइंट इज आर बार. सो मास मोमेंट इज कैलकुलेटेड मास इनटू पोजीशन वेक्टर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू अ रेफरेंस पॉइंट. डिड यू गेट इट?
यस सर.
हां भाई, ठीक है. अब बात करते हैं सेंटर ऑफ मास का दूसरा डेफिनेशन. व्हाट इज सेंटर ऑफ मास का पहला वाला डेफिनेशन व्हिच आई गिव यू इन द फर्स्ट स्लाइड? Hello, hello, hello. Bolo.
It is the point where all the masses of the system of particles are supposed to be concentrated.
Concentrated. Very good, beta. Bahut sahi hai. Abhi center of mass ka dusra definition. Center of mass in terms of mass moment. Second definition. In case of system of particles, center of mass is defined as a point about which mass moment of all particles is zero. Means what? Suppose two particle system is there, M1 and M2. center of mass yahan par kidhar hai, let the distance be r1 and r2. So center of mass se yahan ka position vector rahega r2 bar, ye direction mein, and yahan se position vector rahega r1 bar, which will be in the negative direction. Hello, 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 yes or no?
Yes sir.
Are bhai vector hai na. So according to this definition, the mass moment of all the particles about the center of mass has to become zero, means m1 into r1 with a minus sign because ye direction is taraf hai, plus m2 into r2 should become equal to zero. Hello, hello, hana bolo beta.
Yes
sir. Summation of mass moments about the center of mass has to become zero. That's why we say that m1 r1 will become equal to m2 r2. Hello, hello, yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? Bolo. Clear hai na? Ye cheez hai. Or you can also write this as ye definition ko agar hum likhna chahe to hum aise bhi likh sakte, summation of I ranging from 1 to n mi ri bar is equal to zero. भाई दो था तो दो है ना, तीन रहेगा तो तीन रहेगा विद अ माइनस और द प्लस साइन. हेलो, आर यू ऑल गेटिंग इट? यस और नो? इट्स फाइन. नाउ वी गो अहेड विद सेंटर ऑफ मास ऑफ टू पार्टिकल सिस्टम. Suppose there is a two particle system, there is m1 and there is m2. Center of mass idhar kidhar lie kar raha hai mujhe pata nahi hai. Let this distance be r1, let this distance be r2, and let the whole distance be r. Pehla equation, can I say r will become r1 plus r2? Hana bolo, yes or no? Hello. And can I say according to the definition of center of mass, the mass moment about the center of mass has to become zero. That means m1 r1 will become equal to m2 r2. Hello, hello, please reply yes or no. Correct hai kya?
Yes sir.
Ab in dono ko agar hum solve karenge na, in dono ko agar main simultaneously solve karu to mujhe r1 ka value to aapko seedha yaad rakhna hai will be m2 into r upon m1 plus m2. Similarly, R2 will become M1 into R upon M1 plus M2. This comes in the exam. अब ये इसको याद कैसे करेंगे? एकदम इजी है. देखो ये सब सॉल्व नहीं करना है. R1 will be, यहां पर अगर 1 है ना यहां पर 2 आएगा, और यहां पर अगर 2 है ना तो यहां पर 1 आएगा. What will be R1? The other mass into R upon M1 plus M2. What will be R2? The other mass, that is m1 into r upon m1 plus m2. Are you understanding? Chalo ek kaam karte hain, ek example lete hain. Suppose this is 2 kg. And this is 5 kg. And the distance between them is 10 meter. Center of mass idhar kidhar hai mujhe pata nahi hai. Let this be r1 and let this be r2. Chalo r1 find karke batao, shortcut. R1 कैसे फाइंड करेंगे? R1 क्या रहेगा? Come on, fast.
M2 R by M1 plus M2.
तो नंबर बोलो, नंबर नंबर नंबर. Tell me the numbers. Yes.
5 into 10.
10 upon
7.
Yes or no? अच्छा कोई बता सकता है? Will be R2. जल्दी जल्दी man, जल्दी जल्दी. Time pass वाले सम से, come on. 2 into 10.
10 upon 2 plus.
Did you understand? Did you understand? Ye neet mein bahut baar aaya hai, bahut baar. Getting it or not? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So, isko to seedha yaad hi kar lo. This is the trick. Huh? Seedha seedha yaad karo. Ye trick hai. Rather than solving everything and all that things. Seedha seedha ye two particle system ka trick yaad kar lo. That will be a better thing rather than remembering everything. Now I'm doing center of mass of n particle system. This was two particle system, now be n particle system. Suppose there is coordinate axis hai aapke paas, x, y, and z. और यहां पर बहुत सारे पार्टिकल्स हैं m1 कोऑर्डिनेट्स इज x1 y1 z1 m2 mn बोलो हेलो सेंटर ऑफ मास इधर किधर रहेगा आई डोंट नो इसके कोऑर्डिनेट्स रहेंगे x कॉम y कॉम Z com. Do you agree with me? Hello. Yes, do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
X com will be M1 X1. Formula hai. See the formula. Yaad rakhna. M2 X2. Dot 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 MN XN upon M1 plus M2 plus dot 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 MN. Vaise hi Y com will be M1 Y1, M2 Y2, MN YN upon M1 plus M2 plus dot 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 MN. Z com kya rahega? Come on, will be Z com, man.
M1 Z1 plus M2 Z2.
Yeah. So, isme you strike on the applications. Hello. Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? Clear? Hai?
Yes, sir.
This is how you do x com, y com, and z com. Similarly, r com, position vector of center of mass, will be m1 r1 bar, m2 r2 bar, mn rn bar upon m1 plus m2 plus dot dot. What will be R1 bar? R1 bar comprises of X1 I cap plus Y1 J cap plus Z1 K cap. Hello? Hello? Yes or no? Similarly R2, yes. Similarly Rn. So, yahan par jab aapne X com, Y com, Z com dhoon liya, to wahan par answer aapko aa jayega. That I can prove it later on. But ye cheez aapko samajh mein aana chahiye because we going to do sums based on introductory exercise on the basis of this only. Okay, if time is there, we'll do it today. Otherwise, we can extend it to next time. Are you all getting this thing? Hello, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, I come to the last part of this center of mass. That is center of mass of continuous objects. Pay attention to me. It is very, very important to understand. Okay. Suppose there's a ring. There's a half ring. Center of mass will be here. And its y center of mass coordinate rahega, y com rahega. 2r by pi. This we need to learn. So next time, whenever we meet, we need to learn all these things for a ring. This is half ring. Huh? You can see it is half ring. Center of mass is lying at a distance of 2r by pi from the center. On the center. Similarly, we have a half disk. Half disk, not full disk. Disk. This is y com. This is center of mass. This is y coordinate of center of mass. will become 4R by 3 pi. ये सब याद रखना है, सब याद रखना पड़ेगा आपको, बिना उसके काम होने वाला नहीं है, ठीक है? We have a hollow hemisphere. We need to sit and learn. This is the center. This is center of mass. This is y com. Y coordinate of center of mass will become r by 2. Hollow hemisphere. Then we have a solid hemisphere. This is center. Center of mass. It's 3R by 8. Then we have a hollow cone. Hollow air. Yeah? Base say. This is COM. This is YCOM. It will be H by 3. H is the height. And lastly, it is a solid cone. At a distance of h by 4 from the bottom. Yes or no? Hello? Did you take screenshot of this thing? Hello? Hello, are you all there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these things we need to learn. Because we are doing applications of this thing. On the basis of this, we'll start with our DC Pandya. That is checkpoint. What are the checkpoint starting number? Yeah. It is 8.1, page number 349. Okay, come on now. There are approximately 15 questions I'll be doing till 10 today. And then some homework. And then we can see what is happening. Look over here, beta, carefully. Hello. First point. Y'all will reply. Huh? Center of mass does not depend on. Come on, tell me. What is the answer? Hello. Are you all there or you're sleeping, man? Center of mass does not depend on whom?
Internal forces
formula mein bhi kahan aaya tha. Center of mass is the position. It will not depend on internal forces. Aapko formula to pata hai na, it depends on mx. X center of mass ka formula kya tha? m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus ... mn xn upon m1 plus m2. It is not depending on any internal or external force. Doesn't depend. Second point. Chalo. Center of mass of a two particle system depends on, divides between. Can I say for two particle system, can I say M1 R1 will become equal to M2 R2? Hello?
Yes. Hello.
So can I say what is R1 upon R2? Can I say distance of center of mass will be inverse to mass? Hello. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Ye important hai. इसके लिए तो हम कहते हैं कि सेंटर ऑफ मास इज लोकेटेड नियर टू हेवियर मास, मतलब हेवियर मास जो रहेगा, सपोज दिस इज वन मास, दिस इज वन मास m1, एंड दिस इज अनदर बिग मास m2, तो सेंटर ऑफ मास कहां रहेगा? यहां पर. कैन आई से इसका आर छोटा रहेगा और इसका आर बड़ा रहेगा? यस और नो? हेलो हेलो मैन, प्लीज रिप्लाई, यस और नो? क्लियर है? जिसका मास बड़ा है उसका डिस्टेंस छोटा है सेंटर ऑफ मास से. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड. ओके, एंड फॉर दिस वीक्स एग्जाम, that is combo exam is there on college doors, you will study from the either from the medical gallery or from the 32 years book which I have sent you in PDF. okay, so that will be the case. Please study from that, all the chapters. You all will get acquainted with last year's papers also. Now I'm starting with question number 3. Pay attention to me here. Two bodies of mass 1 and 2 kg are lying at minus 1,2 and 2,4. What are the coordinates of center of mass? Very simple. Come on, tell me the formula for x com. Jaldi, jaldi. Come on. Jaldi bolo.
Minus 1 and...
m1 x1 plus m2 x2 upon m1 plus m2. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
But what is m1? This is m1. What is M2? This is M2. This is X1, Y1. And this is X2, Y2. Chalo. Now nothing doing. Just substitute. M1 is 1 into minus 1 plus 2 into 2 upon 1 plus 2. Yes or no? Hello? Hello, hello, hello. Bolo. This answer will come what? 3 by 3. That is 1. And y com kya rahega? M1, Y1. 1 M1 plus M2. That is 1 into Y1. Y2 is 4. And 10 by 3. Yes or no? Hello. Baba, tell me. Hello, hello, hello. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Clear or no? So this is there. Question number 4 par aata hai, 4. A carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide. Containing carbon and oxygen. अच्छा, carbon का mass कितना होता है? अरे बोलो man, carbon का mass कितना होता है?
12.
And O का?
16.
कितना separation है? अब tell me man, 1.2. Minus 10 meter. Yes or no? Can I say this is M1 and this is M2? I want to find the distance of center of mass from carbon. Matlab R1 nikalna hai. Come on, tell me the shortcut for R1. Shortcut for R1.
2R upon M1 plus M2.
To kya ho jayega number mein? 16 into 2. Are you understanding? Hello, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
This will come 0.69 into 10 raised to minus 10 meters. That will come. So this is a very, very important question which they have asked. You have solved by shortcut only directly rather than solving by normal continuous method. Getting it or not? Hello, hello, hello. Bolo.
Yes, sir.
Clear enough? So, ye shortcut, agar aap yaad karenge, bahut sari jagahon par. मेडिकल गैलरी में आपको देखने मिलेगा, बहुत सारे सम्स आ चुके हैं ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस. Okay, now I'm going to go to the fifth question. You can see there is a rod, L-shaped rod. The coordinates of center of mass of the rod. Acha, can I divide the rod into two parts? Can I divide this rod into two parts? The answer, yeah. Ek rod. Aur ye dusra wala rod. हेलो कोई बता सकता है पहले वाले रॉड का सेंटर ऑफ मास कहां पर है पहले वाले रॉड का सेंटर ऑफ मास कौन सी एक्सिस पर है ये फर्स्ट रॉड है ना भाई और ये सेकंड रॉड है चलो बोलो इसका सेंटर ऑफ मास कितना है इधर किधर है ना इसके कोऑर्डिनेट्स क्या है चलो बोलो जल्दी फास्ट
0, L
वेरी गुड सेकेंड वाली का सेंटर ऑफ मास इधर है इसके कोऑर्डिनेट्स क्या है
L by 2, 0
परफेक्ट यू ऑल आर ऑल वेल वर्स्ड विद मैथमेटिक्स यस और नो अच्छा एक और एक चीज है ध्यान देना कैन आई से मासेस के बारे में भी हमको पता नहीं है कैन आई से अगर इसका मास m है इस वाले का मास m है m2 इज m So can anyone tell me iska mass kitna rahega?
2m.
Why did you say so?
Because it's double the length.
Length is double and if we assume that there is uniform rod, ye dekho diya hua hai yahan pe uniform rod. Uniform matlab kya mass will be proportional to length na? To agar mass agar length double ho gaya to mass bhi double ho gaya ki nahi? Hello. Yes or no? Yaar bolo na. Clear
hai?
Now can you tell me what is x com ka formula? M1 x1. So m1 is 2m. x1 is 0. Dekh sakte ho na x1 iska 0 hai na bhai. Hello.
Yes sir.
M2 is m. Next two is L by 2 upon 2M plus M. ये हो जाएगा L by 6. बोलो. Hello. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
L by 6. अच्छा दूसरा वाला क्या रहेगा? Come on. Y com क्या है? Y com का formula क्या रहेगा? M1 is 2M into L. And dusra wala 0 hai, M2 is 0. 1, 3M. Oh, sorry, M and L cancel ho gaya. Ye 3 baj gaya. Kitna ho gaya? Kitna ho gaya, bhai? Can I say X coordinate ye hai, Y coordinate ye hai? Toh, this will be the answer. Hello. Bolo. Is it okay? Baba, say yes or no so I can go ahead.
Yes.
Okay. Question number 6. All particles of the body are situated at a distance of r from the origin. Can I say, take a ring? Can I say all particles are situated at a distance of r from the origin? Are bhai bolo. All particles are at what distance?
R.
R na, sahi to hai? Yes or no? The distance of center of mass from the origin is? Where is the center of mass located of this ring?
At the origin.
At the origin. So it is less than r, more than r, or equal to r?
Equal to r.
इक्वल टू आर कैसे रहेगा, सेंटर ऑफ मास बीच में है ना, जीरो कॉमा जीरो पर है. हेलो इज द सेंटर ऑफ मास एट आर और लेस देन आर? अरे भाई सेंटर ऑफ मास इधर है क्या? सेंटर ऑफ मास
लेस देन आर.
सेंटर ऑफ मास इज लेस देन आर ना, आर पर तो पार्टिकल्स है. हेलो बेटा आर पर तो पार्टिकल्स है, उसका सेंटर ऑफ मास इज एट द ओरिजिन. ओरिजिन मतलब जीरो, जीरो मतलब लेस देन आर के मोर देन आर? हेलो
लेस
देन आर, इट इज लेस देन आर, याद रखना इट इज लेस देन आर. आंसर विल बी लेस देन इक्वल टू आर. गेटिंग इट? हेलो
यस सर.
या
So why are we writing less than equal to r? Less than is correct, but how can it be equal to r?
Very good question. देखो इधर. Suppose there is only one particle from the origin. One particle at a distance of r. Then किसने question पूछा? Where is the center of mass now? बेटा इसका center of mass कहाँ है? Hello. हेलो सेंटर ऑफ मास इधर है ना अभी. ये पार्टिकल का सेंटर ऑफ मास कहाँ रहेगा? इधर ही तो रहेगा.
यस
यस ऑन. तो अभी क्या हो गया? इक्वल टू आर. वन पार्टिकल के लिए इक्वल टू आर, बहुत सारे पार्टिकल्स के लिए लेस देन आर. यस और नो?
यस सर.
गुड क्वेश्चन. ओके आई वाज वेटिंग फॉर दैट ओनली. सी इफ यू डोंट आस्क मी आई विल नॉट, आई विल नॉट गिव यू द आंसर बिकॉज इट इज वेरी मच इन डेप्थ. तो आपको खुद को रैशनैलिटी से सोचना है और क्वेश्चन पूछना है. क्वेश्चन पूछने में क्या है यार, एटलीस्ट आई एम नॉट आस्किंग यू एनी आंसर्स. ओके सो इट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. चलो आगे बढ़ते हैं. क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 पर आते हैं. क्वेश्चन नंबर 7, 8, 9 यू ऑल कैन डू. आई एम कमिंग टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 10. Please complete this. This is a very dry chapter actually. इसमें practice का जरूरत पड़ेगा आपको. इसके बाद में rotational motion mechanics आपका खत्म, is over. तो बस दो chapter है और, and one is SHM, simple harmonic motion. That is very simple. Then we can go to current electricity and all that stuff. तो mechanics को खत्म कर दो. ये दो chapter है. ये थोड़ा है ना. ओके ड्राई चैप्टर है. आई एम नॉट टेलिंग यू डिफिकल्ट है, थोड़ा ड्राई है. बराबर से प्रैक्टिस करना पड़ेगा. सेंटर ऑफ मास ऑफ थ्री पार्टिकल्स 1, 2 एंड 3 लाई अलोंग 1, 2, 3. सो इन तीनों का, अभी मेरी बात सुना, इन तीनों का सेंटर ऑफ मास कहाँ लाई करेगा? हेलो 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 यस और नो? वन के जी, टू के जी, थ्री के जी का सेंटर ऑफ मास कहाँ लाई कर रहा है? हेलो ओके सेंटर ऑफ मास ऑफ अनदर सिस्टम ऑफ पार्टिकल 3 लाइज एट दिस मच. वेयर शुड वी पुट अ पार्टिकल ऑफ मास 5 केजी सो दैट सेंटर ऑफ मास ऑफ द एंटायर सिस्टम लाइज अलोंग द फर्स्ट सिस्टम? ओके ब्यूटिफुली डिजाइंड. सपोज दिस इज 1 केजी, दिस इज 2 केजी and this is 3 kg. इसका सेंटर ऑफ मास कहाँ लाई कर रहा है भाई? इसका सेंटर ऑफ मास कहाँ लाई कर रहा है? बोलो कुछ तो बोलो. लास्ट सम है बेटा, प्लीज टेल मी. हेलो 1, 2, 3. हेलो
यस सर.
1, 2, 3 बराबर है. अच्छा देयर इज अनदर सिस्टम ऑफ पार्टिकल 3 kg. He lies at where?
-1, 3, -1.
Okay. Where should 5 kg be placed? Where should 5 kg be placed? Suppose 5 kg I place it here. So that center of mass lies where? Lies where? Bolo. lies where. Jaldi jaldi, fast one, please.
First system
ka center of mass kahan hai? First system ka center of mass kahan hai? 1, 2, 3. Can I say 5 kg ko aisi jagah par rakhna hai? Okay. 5 kg ko suppose maine idhar rakh diya. Taki iska aur iska center of mass kahan lie kare? Kahan lie kare? Hello? Kahan lie kare? 1, 2, 3. Abhi dekho, ekdam easy question hai. Indirectly, they are telling you there are two particles. There is one is 5 kg and other is 3 kg. Iske coordinates humko malum hai? Iske coordinates humko malum? Nahi hai. Iska center of mass malum hai aapko kahan lie kar raha hai? Hello? Hello, kahan lie kar raha hai? Are you getting it? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello. Did you understand? It was a very easy question. Can I consider this as M1? Can I consider this as M2? And can I consider this as XCOM? Bolo. Matlab ye system maine pakad liya abhi. Getting it or not? Hello? Ye sab kuch kaam ka nahi hai. This is all time pass which is given in the start of the question. Yes or no? Hello, did you understand? Did you get it?
Yes, sir.
Achha, tell me the formula for XCOM. Come on, please be with me. XCOM ka formula bolo.
M1 X1.
M1 plus M2.
XCOM kitna hai? XCOM is 1, na? M1 kitna hai? 5. X1, I don't know. This is X1, Y1 and Z1. So X1, I don't know. M2 is 3 minus 1 upon M1 plus M2, that is 5 plus 3. Are you getting it? Hello?
Yes, sir.
8 will become 5x1 minus 3. So x1 will be kitna ho jayega? Baba, kitna ho jayega? 11 by 5, na? Hello? Hello?
Yes. Achha,
can you tell me what is YCOM ka formula? Jaldi jaldi, man. YCOM kitna hai? 2 hai. M1, 5. Y1, don't know. 3. Y2 is 3. Upon 5 plus 3, that is 8. 8 2s are 16. 16 minus 9 is 7. 7 by 5. Hello. Hello, what am I telling you all? Are you samajh aa rahe kya?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, ZCOM. M1. M2 kitna hai? 3 into minus 2 upon 8. And ZCOM kitna diya hai? 3 diya hai. ZCOM ka answer aapko aayega 6 aayega. Can anyone tell me what is the answer?
None of these.
None of these. Actually, isme hi mil jayega aapko none of these. Dekho, X1 match hi nahi kar raha hai kiske saath. Answer will be none of these only in the start. Getting it? Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, you all will do it till 12 and come next time. 12. If you all have doubts, please ask me. I will be continuing with some important questions of this type and then I'll go to checkpoint 8.2. Okay? Chalo, thank you very much. Take care. Bye.
Thank you.
Yeah. Anyone has some doubt? Haan, beta?
No, not a doubt. Can you go to the whiteboard ka page 2 and 3?
Yes, I can do that.
So when can we collect the new disbander?
Today you can come between 12 to 3.
Okay, sir, thank you.
So you had sent a video also of this. So we have to
see if you want to. This is the same video. Same. But actually, why did I send? Because it's a dry chapter. Some people don't understand. Hello? So for precaution wise, I have sent ki agar aapko samajh nahi aata to wo video aap dekhenge. So that mein I am also there present. So that feeling is much better. Getting it?
Hello. Okay, sir.
If you have understood today's lecture, then usko dekhne ki zarurat nahi hai because it is the same thing. Hello. Agar aapko kuch okay, samajh nahi aata hai to usme aap fir se dekhiye, usko fast forward karke dekhiye aur zyada samajh aayega. Agar nahi aata nahi dekhna hai to koi problem nahi hai. Agar aaj ka lecture samajh aaya to theek hai. Beta, kaun sa ye wala?
Ye ho gaya sir, on the next page abhi.
Next one, this one.
Yes, sir. Can you minimize this? Pura nahi aa raha.
Yes, come on.
Done, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, beta. Take care. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.